Hey guys, this is Salil, co-founder of AdNapu. We make apps for Shopify, and we have an app for Google Shopping Feed as well. Today we will talk about additional countries in Google Shopping Feed, when to use it, when not to use it, right? So you can find the setting in feeds, and if I'm using Content API, which is the programmatic way of updating the feed, you can use any other parameter as well. And you can see that I have multiple countries listed here. What this means is that I'm sending the same product data, maybe with slight variations across these countries in different countries. So let's say if I have 100 products, I'm sending 100 products to United States, 100 products to United Kingdom, 100 products to France in the Google Shopping feed. Instead, I can just send data to one country, right, to United States, for example, and add all other countries as additional countries, right? When should you do it? When you're sure that you're not going to customize your product title or the products based on the country, right? For everywhere you want to send the same data, you can use take help of these additional countries. One thing which might not work well for you is that if you want to show multiple currencies, right, I would go against this approach, right? It is very obvious that if you show your products in pounds in United Kingdom, you will have a higher conversion rate, right? In that scenario, don't use additional countries. But if you want simplicity, you just want to deal with like a lower number of data to edit, then definitely go for the approach of uploading everything in a single country and going to this setting and adding all other countries as additional countries. Hopefully this helps. Thank you.